All right, so honestly, I really don't feel like working out today. But I'm just gonna work out because starting to get results and then starting to feel and look better. Let's see, maybe put it right here. Yeah, so. Damn. Anyways, well, I guess I'm gonna work out today. I mean, I already worked out. My chest, and then I did what did I do? Chest, jump rope, and elliptical today, and then ate a Whole Foods twice for breakfast and dinner. Had some dumplings, like two, and that's it. So I'm gonna work out today. Well, I mean, I'm gonna work out right now. I'm trying to keep it consistent. Try to two workouts in a day. Man. It's my knee. My eye is getting better, so it's not too bad. But I guess let's work out. All right, here we go.
Your bones and even your mind are dependent. So doing your best to maintain good posture and working on your posture over time can actually benefit your confidence and even your testosterone. Next, make sure you're lifting weights. It's actually one of the best things you can do for your testosterone levels as far as activity. For example, researchers recruited male university students that had no previous experience with lifting weights, and they had them follow a weight training program 3 times per week. Thanks to this, the students boosted their testosterone levels by 40% in 4 weeks, and they also lowered their resting cortisol levels by 24%. We have other research that supports this by showing that resistance training upregulates testosterone receptors. This means your body can use testosterone more effectively when you consistently incorporate resistance training. Another proven tip is to simply get enough sleep. Sleep has a significant impact on your testosterone levels. For example, one study found that after a week of participants sleeping 5 hours a night instead of 8 hours a night, their testosterone levels dropped by around 15%. Another study that recruited over 500 men also found a link between sleep duration and testosterone levels. The scientists found that each extra hour of sleep raised testosterone by roughly 15%. So try your best to get enough sleep, which for most people is going to be somewhere between 7 and 9 hours of sleep per day. You'll also want to decrease stress as much as possible. Short-term stress, like having a deadline or even being excited when trying something new, like skiing, for example, that kind of acute stress may actually even be beneficial for your health. However, chronic stress, like ongoing financial problems, being trapped in a job that you don't like, or an unhappy marriage, can really mess with your testosterone levels. This is because chronically high levels of the stress hormone cortisol impair testosterone production inside your body. You see, cortisol requires pregnenolone for its creation, which is the same building block required for testosterone's creation. That's why cortisol can rob the raw materials your body needs to make testosterone. So try to reduce stress levels with some proven techniques like exposing yourself more to nature, meditating, and developing a more flexible mindset. Now, everyone knows that increasing testosterone is one of the best things you can do for your sex life. But did you know that it also works the other way around? For example, we have a study that shows that testosterone levels rise on the days that couples have sex, and they decline on the days that they don't. And another study found that it could increase testosterone by as much as 72%. So that's something to keep in mind. The bottom line is that the more sexually active you are, the more you create a positive feedback loop, leading to improved testosterone levels. Next, you'll want to reduce your exposure to man-made chemicals like BPA, parabens, phthalates, and benzophenones. The truth is that today, the environment is loaded with anti-androgens, which are compounds that lower testosterone and prevent testosterone from binding to its receptor. For example, plastic water bottles and plastic meal containers are loaded with BPA, which is a compound used to harden plastic. Studies show that BPA lowers testosterone and can even cause erectile dysfunction. It's especially problematic to heat plastic because that causes much more of the anti-androgen compounds to leak into your meal or beverage. Other examples of products with high levels of anti-androgens are air fresheners, certain shampoos, soaps, shaving creams, moisturizers, and even deodorants.
Nothing's good for you in this world.
Now, as far as your diet goes, you definitely want to optimize your dietary fat intake. Low-fat diets are bad for your testosterone levels. For example, one study moved participants from a diet containing 40% of the calories from lean fat to a diet containing 25% of the calories from lean fat. The results showed that testosterone increased when fats were above 40%, but they plummeted when they were below 25%. So make sure you're eating enough dietary fat, but keep in mind that not all fats are created equal. The ones that have the most beneficial effects for your testosterone are saturated and monounsaturated fatty acids. Meanwhile, trans fat has a negative effect. Another thing that's proven to have a negative effect is excessive alcohol consumption. Research shows that light drinking doesn't necessarily have an adverse effect on testosterone, but heavy drinking can highly increase testosterone levels. So try to only drink in moderation and don't drink too much in one sitting. Also remember that it's better to go with liquor or wine instead of beer, because the hops found in beer can impair testosterone on their own because they're estrogenic. Now, a preventative that can actually boost testosterone quite a bit is to take a hard look at the prescription drugs that you're taking. Of course, this should be done with the supervision of your doctor, and I'm not saying at all that you should stop taking your prescribed medications. However, there's no doubt Supplements, one that you might have heard of before is ashwagandha. This is a herb that's used in an ancient Indian medicine practice, and there's evidence that it can have a positive effect. For example, in an 8-week study, men with infertility problems found that 675 grams of ashwagandha root extract increased serum testosterone levels by 17% compared to a placebo. And another study found that just 5 grams of ashwagandha a day for 90 days increased testosterone by 16 to 40% in infertile men and by an average of 15% in fertile men. To reap the benefits, it's recommended that you take 300 to 500 milligrams of a root extract with a meal, ideally for breakfast. Another proven supplement is Tongkat Ali, which is a herbal medicine that comes from a shrubby tree native to Southeast Asia. It has a long tradition of being used for boosting male potency, and research backs up that it can actually help. For example, one group of moderately stressed participants increased their testosterone levels by 37% and lowered their cortisol by 16% as a result of consuming 200 milligrams of this supplement for 4 weeks. For this one to be effective, it's recommended that you have 200 to 300 milligrams of 100 to 1 extract concentration, which equals 20 to 30 grams of this herb in its dry root form. Forest Colon is another supplement that has a long history as a folk remedy for asthma. Although it won't fix asthma, it may increase testosterone. A 12-week double-blind study involving overweight and obese men found that taking a Forest Colon extract twice per day raised testosterone levels by over 33%. Now, there are natural foods that you can also use to help with testosterone. Ginger root is a perfect example of this. While ginger is usually appreciated for its anti-inflammatory properties, not many people know that it can also be used to boost your testosterone levels. We have a number of studies on rodents that prove this, and a human study that found that consuming ginger daily for 90 days was able to increase testosterone by over 17% in infertile men. Unfortunately, the study doesn't really say how much ginger the participants consumed daily, but for most people, 1 to 3 grams per day is the recommended amount. Another thing that you should definitely do if you feel that you're having testosterone issues, especially out of the blue, is to go get checked out. Sure, you can optimize your diet, your sleep schedule, your exercise routine, and take the right supplements, but if things aren't working right on a deeper level, then your testosterone can still be taking a beating. This is because the Leydig cells of your testicles produce about 95% of the testosterone in your body. So if you suffer from low testosterone symptoms, even though you're doing everything right, it's probably a good idea to get checked out by a doctor. One of the most common issues that men have in this department is known as varicocele. This is the medical term for partially blocked veins, which can lead to low sperm production, decreased sperm quality, infertility, and of course, low testosterone. In fact, according to the University of Iowa, varicoceles are the most common cause for male factor subfertility, accounting for up to 40% of the cases. They also state that this condition can be found in nearly 15% of all men. In other words, it's pretty common, so don't be afraid to go get it checked out. Finally, something that men can do as they get older is testosterone replacement therapy. Again, I'm not advocating for this at all, and you should definitely consult with your doctor about the pros and the cons. If none of the natural tips work well enough to bring your testosterone levels back up to the level that you want, you can always consider starting testosterone replacement therapy, or TRT. This isn't something to take lightly, though, because it'll cause your natural testosterone production to slow down or to be shut down completely, and it can have adverse consequences, especially when TRT is used irresponsibly. So if this is something that you're considering, make sure you talk to a doctor or an endocrinologist. This can help you decide whether it's right or wrong for you, and if it's right for you, what the best way is to move forward. So those are 17 science-based tips that you can start implementing today to boost your testosterone levels. If you enjoy...
13 minutes, jeez. Oh, man. I'm tired already.
Collection based on the Jisoo. Dior announced that they were impressed by Jisoo while preparing the 2021 Autumn and Winter collection. When you see the clothes on the fashion show, you will realize that Dior really sent Jisoo as her muse because every outfit is reminiscent of Jisoo. However, as Dior prepared an Autumn and Winter collection for Jisoo, there was another reason why Dior never wanted to miss Jisoo. It's because she raised Dior's brand sales to a tremendous level. Even Dior's CEO was rumored to have been surprised by her influence. In fact, in a 2021 survey of the most influential brands,
melted down and made into these little pellets. Almost anything restaurant thing like that. I think she'd bring it. There's still a few hours before the open, so I'm starting to get out with something right for the sponsor of this video, Magic Show. Anyway, I've been talking about a couple of years now. There's still something I need all the time. When I'm home, I often use this as a meal replacement when I don't want to eat something for dinner or breakfast. Also, I told you guys this. I am obsessed with cereal. I don't walk down cereal aisles in the grocery store because I know I'm too weak. And also, I need to have both pretty much pure sugar.
This nigga!
Here's why I love it. First of all, it's extra. It definitely satisfies that inner cereal monster that you know lives inside you. But each serve is 0 grams of sugar. Well, the Honey Nut Butter has 1 gram of sugar. 13 to 14 grams of protein, 140 calories, and only 4 net grams of carbs. Also, it's gluten-free, grain-free, soy-free, low-carb, and keto-friendly. I think I showed you guys before, I used to drink a couple servings of protein powder a day. Now, it just has trust me, much more fun to chicken. Also, it's never boring. There's so many different flavors like blueberry, cocoa, fruity cookies, and cream, frosted peanut butter, maple waffle, cinnamon roll, and you can choose your own variety box and fill it with whatever flavors you want. So if you want to give it a try, go to the link down below. I can build your own variety box and use my promo code Mikey Chan for $5 off. You can choose from all the flavors I mentioned before, and now Magic Spoon is actually adding honey nuts to their permanent collection. So we should add honey nuts to the variety box and check it out. Also, what I love about Magic Spoon is that they have 100% happiness guarantee. So if you don't like it for whatever reason, get your money. Again, use promo code Mikey Chan for $5 off, which is magicspoon.com/MikeyChan, and save $5 off your order today. Also, if you're in Canada or the UK, now Magic Spoon delivers there too. Alright, I'm going to finish this and see you lunch. This is an amazing food there. First of all, it hits to a cool new pizza place that has a lot of other unique items, lobster pizza. Then head into a newly opened Japanese restaurant that serves just a ginormous piece of meal over rice. Anyway, I'm starving, haven't eaten anything all day. Let's get this food day started right here at Detroit Pizza.
I knew it. I knew it.
There's more places to go, so I'll stick with two pizzas for now. Can't wait for this. They recommend they're taking this famous soda company, Australian made. Slicing the rib table side, and this is what's gonna go on top of the pizza. How amazing is this? And again, the smoky smell from the meat is just intoxicating at this point. It's a Sicilian type pie. Square caramelized crust looks like so much cheese, and of course, this amazing giant layer of meat freshly cut and placed on top. And besides how good this meat smells, look at the marbling on this thing. And this is a tall slice of pizza. Again, caramelized crust, so pretty on the sides, on the bottom, loaded with cheese. I don't think my mouth ever watered from pizza. As I was saying, if you're in Korea right now, or if you're thinking about coming here on your way here, whatever your situation is, this needs to be near or at top of your food bucket list. Do you like pizza? Where do you like ribs? Where you're just in general fan of delicious, awesome food? Holy, this is good. I mean, I love the lobster pizza, but the beef one is just gonna blow your mind away. Like right now, I'm pretty sure I have no mind. First of all, the meat is just melts in your mouth. There's so much marbling on this meat. It just disintegrates when it touches your tongue. The cheese is high quality, and it's crushed. I mean, K-pop from Kiwi writing songs about this crush. It looks a little intimidating because it's so tall, but it's just pure air. And the caramelized outside is better than any. Deep dish pizza, I've had it in New Lash, in the lobster one. Again, with that great crust, sweetness of the lobster tail, it's just met with that fiery, creamy chipotle sauce on top. Each piece, absolutely amazing in its own way. It just makes me want to try every other pizza.
In the world right now, but it's a lesson for us to see how people have been able to help their neighbors. That creates solidarity, friendship, compassion.
St. Jude was founded with an understanding that no child should die in the dawn of life. Nothing stops in the way of us achieving that mission, not even war. So St. Jude serves as one of the partners.
Cheese goes so well with any dessert item. It goes well with coffee, it goes well with waffles, pretty much anything sweet. You put this magical cheese on, it just tastes better. And honestly, having a fresh croffle, it's such a long time. It's one of my favorite things to eat in South Korea. This cheese is like tailor-made for ice cream.
That looks good.
Rice with the egg yolk on top. I'm not really sure what kind of bread the tonkatsu is covered in, but it looks perfectly cooked, very juicy. This is really, really good. Some of that yolk touching everything, and the rice with that inside the coat with a piece of the katsu. That's still not quite sure what is on the bread on the outside. It's that green. You fucking absolutely screaming now. And then he just ramps up the intensity for the next minute or so. The meat is so juicy. But yeah, it's absolutely perfect. I don't think there's too much additional flavor from the outside. It just provides such a great textural contrast. It's such a delightful bite. This not only looks great, I thought, when I saw a picture of this, I'm thinking, yeah, I'm gonna go eat it because it looks really good. This thing tastes as good as it looks. And this is a meal I'm talking about. This is like a giant piece of meal over rice over tomato. On the side, they give you some seaweed to wrap the eel in. Let's just take a little piece of it. First of all, here, I think, we're supposed to be cutting the eel.
Consumers rely on technology to connect with people, to go places, to buy things.
Add it to shopping list.
And while the cost of everyday life continues to rise, technology provides the tools that consumers need to compare prices and businesses need to compete. Our economy relies on the competition that comes from technology and innovation. Tell Senator Raphael Warnock to protect.
And after the awesome katsu and the meal right down the street, check this out. Just ran into this place. This is so great about walking around these neighborhoods. Look at this. It's called Shi'ai. Looks like a beef noodle soup place. I don't know what that is. I think this is sweet and sour pork and mapo tofu. I use some beef noodle soup. All this is super affordable too, so about $7 for beef noodle soup. This is it, beef noodle soup. Giant pieces of shank. My chopsticks completely sinked into that. These are nice pieces too. Look, there's a piece of tendon right there. That's a great piece. I mean, each of these giant pieces of beef is so freaking tender. Noodle looks good. I asked for the maximum spiciness. Just added some vinegar to this. Now it's spicy, it's yummy, it's sour as well. That's good. This beef is just legendary. Alright. I put that in my mouth. I kind of just squished it to the roof of my mouth and my tongue. Whole thing just disintegrated. also brought over some cream cheese hide. That stuff's great. This mop is over. Some minced meat in here. Definitely tons of sauce. Okay, I got some mixed feelings about this. On the one hand, it's really spicy. I asked for maximum spiciness, and it freaking delivered. This will burn me. There's tons of minced meat in here. It's tofu. It's extremely tender. It all goes great with the rice. It's nummy. It's spicy. It's extremely flavorful. My only problem with this, it's really sweet. The mapo tofu on YouTube, you're not supposed to be sweet. The overall flavor is really good. It was maybe 60-70% less sweet. This would be absolutely perfect. Wow, it's tons of fire. So much good flavor in the top double. Wow, they're definitely not messing around with that. And this is a really interesting dish. I'm not quite sure what this is. I think it's some sort of stir-fried chicken with scallions and fried rice. Oh, I love this. This is so bad. This is so bad. Level 4 mapo tofu, just unrelenting. This dish definitely really needs a little crispy garlic. Some chilies on this too. It's basically ground chicken. And this is, oh man, I forgot the name of this vegetable. We eat this a lot in Chinese cooking. It's garlic sprouts. Garlic sprouts, one of the most delicious vegetables out there. This is stir-fried out on its own, or stir-fried with meat. The crunch is awesome. It's got a little garlic flavor. Oh, this is a great dish. Again, tad sweet, still so good. I'm just punishing myself with mapo tofu right now. I know a lot of dishes in Korea are slightly sweet. And that's just a whole preference thing. Like, some people probably love it. Love the mapo tofu. Love this chicken dish with a bit more sweetness than I do. Growing up in northern China, I'm just really not used to the sweetness. But these are great dishes. This is an amazing restaurant. So if you are in Seoul and hankering for some beef noodle soup mapo tofu, this is a really good place. And if you like your spice, I would recommend the level 4 mapo tofu. I mean, it's going to make you sweat. It's going to make your nose run. But oh my goodness, is it ever satisfying. I kind of wish I'd save the dessert for after this. Come on. I love coming here and looking at the new Starbucks mugs. Oh, this one is so cool. It's like a big tulip. Barista milk cream cake. These are all stuff that's only for Korea. And also, mint chocolate chip blended peach and lemon blended. Yuja mint tea. This is a lemon peach blended.
Alright. So, just finished working out. Well, workout's not that bad. About 36 minutes with the stretch.
Sour sweet, real chunks of the peaches in here. Every time I come to South Korea, go to Starbucks and try one of these like Colmia.
Usually get over, usually about 1,000 or around 1,000 on my calories. Yeah, just recording one day at a time. What I've been eating is a lot of whole foods. I'll try to record that. You know, I keep forgetting to record what I eat, but I usually spend about like $8 to $12 every time I go there. And so it's not too much food. If you've ever been to Whole Foods, you can easily overspend on food, but the food quality is really good. Yeah, I'm trying to improve my neck. Get that to really good looking, you know, just pretty much just overall appearance, just hopefully gets better looking. But other than that, see you guys in my next video, and then I'll probably record my weight tomorrow, see where I'm at. I'm probably like around 160, 161, maybe 159, but I don't think I'm that low again. But I'm trying to work to get to 155. By the end of this month, you know, hopefully I can do it. All right. Till then, see you guys.